Namaskar and welcome to e-news of IPR department. I'm Manisha, presenting you the news bulletin. Honorable Governor Shri Ganga Prasad launched the Water Sanitation and Hygiene Project and mobile application in a program held at Chintan Bhawan Gangtok yesterday. The launching program, organized by Education Department with the support of Elkem Laboratories and Sulabh Sanitation and Social Reforms Movement, which was also attended by Honorable Minister for Education Shri Kunga Nima Lepcha, Additional Chief Secretary Shri G.P. Upadhyaya, Sulabh Sanitation Group founder and Padma Bhushan awardee Shri B. Pathak, principals, teachers and students. Addressing the gathering, Governor Ganga Prasad said, "School children are the main driving force of change in their household, society and communities." He said that the launch of WASH program in all government schools will make an impact in Sikkim, as it was good record in past where people were imparted with the knowledge of hygienic practices across the country, he remarked. Education Minister Kunga Nima Lepcha expressed his gratitude to founder of Sulabh Sanitation and Social Reforms Movement and Padma Bhushan Dr. Bindeswar Pathak for implementing such project in Sikkim. The minister expressed pride in the fact that Sikkim is leading the effort in the nation's cleanliness drive. Under Garima project, two best schools, namely Rangpo Government Senior Secondary School and Yaksam Government Senior Secondary School, were awarded best schools. Likewise, best teacher was awarded to Ambika Dhakal from Timi Government Senior Secondary School, South Sikkim. Subsequently, five volunteers were also awarded with best volunteers. Also on 23rd December, Honorable Governor of Sikkim Shri Ganga Prasad has paid homage and rich tribute to late Swami Shraddhanand on his 93rd death anniversary. A renowned educationist and social reformer, Swami Shraddhananda was a prolific Arya Samaj missionary who established universities and educational institutions in his pursuits to change the society through education. He also worked tirelessly towards bringing harmony and mutual trust between fragmented Indian society during early 20th century. Honorable Chief Minister Shri P.S. Tamang attended Golden Jubilee celebration at Lingtam Senior Secondary School on 23rd December. Addressing on the occasion, Chief Minister informed that the education is the priority of the government. He highlighted that the government is soon setting up UPSC coaching centers in the state to produce more civil servants. He stated, students studying outside state are facing hardship availing college hostels, for which government is coming up with different hostels in all metropolitan cities for their convenience. He informed that Gurukul Siksha system would also be introduced in the education institutions. Further, he appealed the people to send their kids to the government schools and make more contributions to the local schools. Earlier, Chief Minister also visited Karma Samtin Choling Gumpa, located at Makaibari, Rongli. He offered his prayers and interacted with the devotees and people present there. A coordination meeting of the Department of Sports and Youth Affairs was held on 23rd December at Paljor Stadium Conference Hall, Gangtok. The meeting was presided by Sri Kuber Bhandari, Secretary Department of Sports, Youth and Affairs, Government of Sikkim. During the meeting, it was informed that the Inter-Constituency Football Tournament 2019-20 under Rural Sports will be conducted in two different venues at Jorthang and Paljor Stadium in the first round. The first round will be played at Jorthang Playground during the occasion of Mange Sangranti. The entries should be completed by 28 December 2019 and the fixture will be drawn in the Chamber of Honorable Minister, Department of Sports and Youth Affairs, Government of Sikkim on 3rd January 2020. Sporting activities at all Gram Panchayat level under RDD will be conducted as per the decision of the government. The Sports Department will give full technical support for conducting these sports activities. The department will also conduct the Winter Coaching and Talent Hunt program in 13 sports disciplines at 4 districts as usual from 5th January 2020 to 31st January 2020. Another program of the Talent Hunt will also be conducted for under 13 and under 15 year boys football players. On 23rd December, the Honorable Minister for Agriculture, Horticulture, Shri Loknath Sharma, attended Denzong Losoong celebration being held at the community playground at Ralong. Addressing the gathering, Minister Sharma threw light on the celebration of series of festivals of various communities in different parts of the state and applauded privilege of secular freedom in practice in tune with peace and harmony. The minister spoke on various schemes and programs dedicated to the farmers being implemented under Agriculture, Horticulture and Animal Husbandry and Veterinary Services Department, and further encouraged to increase milk production by taking benefits of financial incentives to be implemented from the next financial year. Minister Sharma also shared that the state government commitment to expedite the developmental pace and other activities from the next financial year. He also touched upon the future scope of Integrated Process Unit of Sikkim, IFFCO Organic Limited. On 22nd December, Chief Minister Shri Prem Singh Tamang laid the foundation stone of two integrated processing units of Sikkim IFFCO Organic Limited in Rangpo, East Sikkim, in the presence of Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Government of India, Shri Narendra Singh Tomar. The program also saw the unveiling of Sikkim IFFCO Organics Limited logo by the Chief Minister and Union Minister. Speaking on the occasion, Chief Minister Shri Prem Singh Tamang said that the joint venture between Government of Sikkim and IFFCO Organics Limited has been envisaged to ensure that the farmers of Sikkim will get the rightful market for their products, both nationally and internationally. He added that Sikkim is the first state of India to get 100% organic, committing itself to attend sustainable agriculture and to promote the green Himalayan economy. Thus, in order to protect the status of all the organic produce of the state, the integrated processing units will be processing and packaging these high-value crops and market them outside the state. He said that the joint venture is a step in the direction of a safer food supply chain and environment protection. He emphasized on the point that this joint venture will ensure that the state of Sikkim fulfills the mission of doubling farmers' income highlighted by the Government of India. The Chief Minister stressed that the processing unit is being set up in Rangpo particularly because it is the gateway town and it would be convenient to market the produce outside the states. Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Shri Narendra Singh Tomar, applauded IFFCO and Government of Sikkim's initiative to strengthen organic agriculture in the country and honing its capability to provide livelihood to the local farmers, which will help in boosting economy of northeastern states of India as they are predominantly dependent on agriculture. This project is in line with the vision of Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi's strategic thinking and planning to boost organic farming in the country, hence doubling farmers' income in 2020. On 20th December, Honorable Minister for Agriculture and Horticulture Shri Loknath Sharma made a surprise visit at the subdivisional level office of Horticulture Department at Rongli. He interacted with the officials including Deputy Director, Development Officer, Horticulture Inspector and other staff and took details on the facilities and services availed by the subdivisional level office. He also briefed the employee appointed under the One Family One Job scheme and enlightened efforts of the state government under the leadership of the Honorable Chief Minister Sri P.S. Tamang to continue their entitlement and further encouraged them to be more dedicated and determined to fulfill the assigned duty honestly and sincerely. This much for today. We'll be back with the more updates. Thank you.